All right, we are leaving our parking spot at Bellevue at an apartment. Paid $6 for 2 hours. It was $4 for 1 hour. Not bad. But we are headed toward the mall now. We need to find what we wanted here. We need to find a sporting goods store. There's a lot going on around here. A lot of people walking around, cars. So we're gonna go left. If we gotta pay attention. So I crossed a busy street and we had 3 seconds left. I was very proud of myself. So the ice skating rink looked really busy. So I'm hoping we can get a handicap spot at the mall. They should have a ton of them. Here's the parking lot for the park. I can't believe how many people are out. I mean, it's raining. It is kind of warmish. It's not super cold. A lot of people out there today. And I'm not sure if I can turn into the parking lot I want from here, but we're gonna try. This is the one I know. Looks like you can. Changed, or I'm not where I think I am. Oh, I am not where I think I am. We gotta go straight yet. Should I get over? Okay. Oh, I can't turn here. That's alright. We'll figure it out. So they have a surface line here. This is where we always park in the corner. We'll just go in the next one we see at this point, though. Wow, so in front of us on the right, that used to be a parking lot with a Safeway. Now it's an apartment building with a Safeway on the ground floor. That has changed a lot. I mean, all this has changed a ton in the last 10, 20 years. Yeah, we'll go left up here in the main parking lot. Oh, there's a Bellevue Arts Museum. I think we went to that. I can't remember though. Crosswalk here, but there's no light telling you people are crossing. Alright, we're going left here. Oh, you can't. Wow. Shoot. Guess we gotta try the next entrance. Ooh. might not actually stop here. We might have to go big five all the way home if we can't get a parking spot here. Farzi Cafe. Modern Spice Bistro. Must be Middle Eastern. Sounds good. Oh, Cactus, we ate there. That's a really good Mexican chain restaurant at the mall. We got stuck on this walkway once during the Christmas festivities. It was a nightmare. Just packed full of people. We never came back for that. Not worth it. They have a parade on the street here. Yeah, if there's a line to get into the parking garage, we'll just leave. Should we just leave? This is way busier than I expected. Of course, it is the week after Christmas still. We'll try it. Take the 520 bridge back, pay the toll. Haven't done that for a while. And then take Mercer Street exit if we can get over and drive through downtown Seattle. Apartments here, and they're super expensive. Well, you got all the tech workers here, they can afford it. Probably like $3,000 a month minimum for one bedroom. I think Seattle's like $2,500 for a newer building. Make this. This is gonna be a separate video, maybe. Bellevue, Seattle video. Wow, so you can't even turn left here, so we're gonna leave. That's enough of this. You gotta go around the mall clockwise to get in. Stop at, yeah, we'll just go home. We have a big five, a couple of them in the area. So say we can stop at South Center, but I've never been there. I don't know if I want to go there. Probably a zoo. Oh, they have these candies here. I think I went to this store before. Back roads to 520 if I can. can't remember if it was when we left or moved back. The houses people bought here that they were going to tear down were like $650,000, and they build their mega mansion. It must have been 2010. I don't remember exactly. I just was thinking, wow, it'd be nice to buy one of those old houses, but people would just pay cash for them. I was reading in articles, tear them down for that price back then. That's the way, the only way you could live here. This is actually a nice way to leave Bellevue instead of trying to get on 405 like we used to do. Of course, you gotta pay the toll on the bridge if you're trying to get the I-90. It's free. We haven't taken the bridge for a while though, 520. I want to see how the rest of the construction is going. I think they gotta be done almost on the university side. Parks we want to try and find, but since we didn't find what we want, I think we still need to try and find sporting goods stores. We'll come back up here.
In 1/3 of a mile, use the 2 left lanes to turn left to Washington 520 West.
So there's some parks way up on the north side of 405 where it meets I-5.
In 1/4 of a mile, use the 2 left lanes to turn left to Washington 520 West.
And then the Redmond area has a bunch of parks that we need to check out someday that we've never been to, or I've never been to at least.
Washington 520 West.
So we were talking to the lady at the store we went to in Bellevue, and she swims at a Y that has an outside pool. I didn't know they had those here. And it's 82 degrees. And she loves it. I guess 82 wouldn't be bad when you're swimming. 40 or 50 degrees outside.
In 2 miles, there is a toll gate. Proceed 6 miles on Washington 520.
Jogging across it. It's a long ways. Someday we'll have to walk across it when I'm walking that far again. This spring it would be fun to park somewhere and walk across it. Or even bike across it. Bring our bikes up here. So you can see how this bridge is level, whereas the I-90 bridge leans, and I think it's because of the train tracks are so much heavier on that side. Or maybe this bridge is just made better, I don't know.
Third of a mile, turn right.
So they are still working on this part. Wow, this is like a 10-15 year project, this whole bridge.
In one quarter of a mile, turn right to Montlake Boulevard East and then make a U-turn if possible. Boulevard East and then make a U-turn if possible.
A lane shift.
Proceed 3 miles on Washington 520.
That'd be fun to go to REI. I haven't been to this REI in literally 15 years, probably. It's the flagship at REI. Thank you.
2 miles, use the two right lanes to take exit 165A on the right to 6th Avenue towards James Street.
That wasn't bad. Lucky.
Start now. In 1/3 of a mile, turn left. In 1/4 of a mile, turn left to Fairview Avenue North.
This part of Seattle in the last 15 years has changed a lot. There used to be nothing here. Building crane fell on it when they were building it on the right there.
Turn left to Fairview Avenue North.
There are a lot of good restaurants in this area now. Hopefully they're still open. I think a lot of this is Amazon workers, and they're back in the office 5 days a week. They have to be. This used to be vacant lots and junky warehouses and stuff. Yeah, after we go to REI, we'll head home and try and find a sporting goods store in Gig Harbor if they have one. And if not, maybe we don't go to the Y. We'll see. We'll talk about it. There's got to be a sporting goods store in Gig Harbor. Just can't recall where it is. Street since all these new buildings went up. When we moved away, they were still building this area. Very nice.
In 1/4 of a mile, turn left.
It's incredible how dense it is now with apartments. Offices. It's a nice part of downtown. And this is not my turn. Thomas Street. This is Harrison Street. So the buildings to the left in the front that aren't finished, the developer went broke. And I'm not sure they're working on them. They wanted to put a plane in the middle of them, a fuselage. It was really weird, I thought. So it'd be interesting to see if they get finished, someone buys them. I'm pretty sure the plane won't be there anymore.
In 400 feet, turn left to Thomas Street. Turn left to Thomas Street. Yeah. In 1/4 mile, turn right.
Jeez. Pay attention here. People open their doors right in front of you.
In 400 feet, turn right to Yale Avenue North.
Oh, the lunchbox always sounds neat, I think. Wow, there's so many apartments here. Might be a nice place to live.
Turn right to Yale Avenue North.
There's the REI in front of us. Just gotta remember how to get into the parking garage.
In 300 feet, your destination is on your left. Route guidance is now finished.
You do have to pay to come here to park. You didn't used to. Wow. Unless you buy something, then it's free, maybe. Oh my god, what is this? Alright. Handicap spots. Nice. Oh, this is a great spot too. At stores, like literally right there. Nice. Yeah, I missed that placard. Of course, I'd rather walk better, so I won't complain. We are leaving. Oh yeah.
Don't hit anyone. There's that lady.
And not really sure how to get out of here. And this car. I'm not sure if they're trying to park or they didn't want to wait for me to back up. Straight. You have to turn here, otherwise you're going around and around and around. I don't want to do that again. Exit. Yeah, this is, so we found out REI does not own this parking lot anymore. They just started this pay thing a few years ago. But on the weekend you get 3 hours free, you don't have to pay. Wow, it's just crazy how busy it is. It's small. Makes me appreciate our local REIs. I mean, I like this one, but I feel like ours has pretty much everything too. We've always found everything. And wow, you gotta go around a circle to get out now. Part of Seattle is bustling again, for sure. Alright. Oh, I should have turned left there. It's all those buildings that construction stopped. Yeah, I do not miss these narrow streets. This is how get into neighborhoods around downtown. It's like this. Very narrow with the cars parked everywhere. Actually, we're going to try and walk around some of those neighborhoods in the spring though. So there's a giant hole here where they started digging for a building. It looks like they stopped construction. There are coffee houses everywhere here. One in front looks neat. Cascade Coffee Works. Old brick building at the bottom. Car if you worked and lived here. Didn't want one. I just can't get over all the apartments here now. Avenue go south. I want to try and get to third. Touristy things are. Oh, the Amazon campus isn't even there. Instead, some of their buildings in front of us. Wow, I don't remember this park on the right. Man, it's really neat with their Christmas lights, huh? I think on the left there used to be a hotel there, motel that they tore down, or something like that. They haven't developed it yet. On the right, I just don't remember that. It's 3:30 already. Dark in 45 minutes. So we will film as much as we can. So I found out REI has their own electric bike, which I'll have to research. Most of it's made in China though, which I don't want a China bike. And the guy was like, oh, well, they're all made there, but there are some that aren't. And I want the ones that aren't. I want them to be more reliable. Wow, this is... Oh, that is neat. The lights thing of hanging at the Amazon building there. Seattle Bakery looks fun. This whole area is fun. Yeah, that's a one-way street. Yeah, it's not easy driving in Seattle. It's very confusing for me. Just a lot of weird streets going every which way and one ways and things. I feel like you can't turn on red anymore in Seattle. I don't know though. I thought I heard that was a law, or they wanted to make that a law because of all the people. It's probably a smart thing. I mean, look at all this crosswalks here and people. It's just a mess. You got a trolley and buses. I can't imagine how expensive, like there's an apartment in front of us, Cirrus. It must be like crazy expensive to live right there. Probably really nice. Oh jeez, so you turn the corner and immediately there's a stoplight. God, that's what I'm saying, like, weird. You don't expect that. Oh, I kind of want to go right here. I can. So the trolley track is on the right, and there's a trolley coming, and I'm not all the way over, so hopefully it doesn't hit me. Or it's a bus, maybe. I can't tell. It's a bus. Portland is still worse, though. With all their bike lanes and trolley lanes and... I don't know, Seattle's catching up. Alright, so there's the spear. Amazon spear. Yeah, it's just really neat campus they have. I should go right here. Oh, you can't go right here. Never mind. We ate at one of the restaurants here once. It was really good. Walked a lot that day. I think it was during COVID, if I remember right. And I should be able to get to 3rd Avenue from here, and we'll go straight south. Or 1st Avenue, I mean, that's what we want. he's like over the line. I knew he was crying at me. It's a big old long articulated bus. So I thought all the scooters were gone. I'm not sure what companies left, but they're white and green scooters you can rent. Lime went out of business. Those are Lime, so maybe I'm thinking of a different company, or I don't know. I thought they went out of business, bankrupt or something. I think we have to get on third and then get over to first. Yeah, we're not far enough south yet to get on first. I think it's first. I could be wrong. It's been so long. So, oh, we can go here. We'll turn here. Oh my gosh. Left lane restricted. For a second I thought I was on a bus street. All I saw were buses. I did that once. It was kind of scary. So this part of downtown is pretty much deserted now, unfortunately. Wow, it does look rough. Do not enter. So I go this way. Tourists go and all the touristy stuff and fun shops and restaurants and Pike Place Market. Outside lane. So Metzger's Maps is still one of my favorite places to go in this area. Tons of books they have and maps, and just really neat. I like it. Hiking books, travel books, you can get any book. Oh, that's why no one's in this lane. There's people. Parking here. Drop-off zone. Charter bus only there, 15 minutes. Yeah, in the summertime, you do not want to drive through here. Just crazy busy. It's pretty busy now. There are some good restaurants in here. good to see the people back. You don't really see, at least right now, I don't see any homeless people milling around. Looks like it would be safe.
Guidance will start now.
All right, we're getting a map back to the freeway. I don't want to drive on this forever. We're going to take a left on Spring Street. The wheel on the right. We did that once, it was fun.
Friends, in one quarter of a mile, turn left.
Seattle Art Museum. We need to go back there sometime. That's fun. Yeah. Maybe this spring we'll do that. Or late winter, if I'm able to. I will be able to. I need to quit saying if.
Feet turn left to Spring Street.
Yeah, if you don't live here like us, you just drive slow and look around a lot. No one's honked at me, so that's good. We are going left up here. Is my plan. I actually don't know the best place to park down here anymore. Probably in South Lake Union, Amazon area, I find a spot to pay for it.
Turn left to Spring Street.
Ah, these are the hills of Seattle. Snows, they're closed. Huh, something called BB's Teriyaki Grill on the left. Yeah, if we had still lived here where we lived 20 years ago, or 15 years ago, I would say I'd be fat, but I would walk a lot. We just don't eat out that much anymore. You would be tempted to eat out all the time. There are awesome restaurants here. So I was talking to a guy that moved from New York, and he missed the New York restaurants, but there's a lot of restaurants here, I feel. I didn't talk to him. I mean, he was on YouTube, actually, I saw. So we have hill start assist on this car. It's actually really nice on hills like this. You won't go backwards. You take your foot off the brake.
In 1/4 of a mile, use the center lane to turn right to I-5 south.
There's the library on the right. Really neat. We actually have a library card. We can access all the digital ebooks and stuff. It's really neat. They have audiobooks and ebooks you can read. Yeah, tons of them too.
In 500 feet, use the center lane to turn right to I-5 south.
Wow, this is a photo-enforced intersection. Stuck in the middle of that, unless they look at the picture and see if you're stuck or not.
Turn right to I-5 south.
Bus signal up there, and it's white. I can't tell what the signal means. All right, we made it back to the freeway almost. Not quite.
Of a mile, keep left at exit to I-5. In 1/4 of a mile, keep left at the exit to I-5 towards I-5 south and then keep right. Keep left and then keep right. Keep right and then keep left. Keep left and then keep left.
I can't understand what she's telling me to do. it's like we have traffic.
Keep left.
Proceed
31 miles on I-5. Proceed 31 miles on I-5.
To our left. of effort. If we can get stuff on the peninsula. Or even Tacoma. But when you want a special store, it's worth it sometimes. I bought my juicer in Bellevue. I need to get to that and start using it again. It's really good. I made celery, cucumber, pepper, ginger juice type things. Must be an accident. Like, this is horrible traffic Saturday afternoon. Some type of blinking lights up ahead, yeah. What takes is one. We all suffer. Yep. So it looks like there's a merge area up ahead. Someone probably didn't merge properly. Coming off of the West Seattle Bridge. Had a bad day. South Center Mall is here, and I thought about going there, but that place is a zoo between Christmas and New Year's. And I don't really know what's there, so I don't want to waste any more time. Someday.
In half a mile, keep left at exit 2I5. Proceed 2 miles on I-5. In 2 miles, exit right to Washington 16 West. Exit right to Washington 16 West. Exit right to Washington 16 West. Keep right at exit 132B to Washington 16 West towards Gig Harbor. Proceed 1/3 of a mile on Washington 16 West. Proceed 23 miles on Washington 16.
We are going to be in Gig Harbor in 10 minutes. This video.
now finished.
Find out though. my gosh. Never mind. Thought the urgent care was closed, but it's some other business. I was like, all worried. All right, we made it.